This is John Cola with GrownYourGreens.com. Today I have another exciting episode for you. We're here in the middle of San Francisco and I was driving down the street and I heard about this place called Hayes Valley Farm. I saw some videos on YouTube and actually I read an article in the newspaper a little while ago about how they have beehives here. And basically what they did was somebody took Raid or some kind of pesticide and sprayed the bees in the beehives because they thought it was a threat or they didn't like bees being here or something. And they killed the majority of the bees, so that was really saddening for me. And I was lucky enough to be driving by, so we found a parking spot here, parked, and we're gonna make a video today about Hayes Valley Farm. So you can see here, this is just the busy street in the city, but if we just go over this side, you can take a look at what they've done. So up over here is the hill, and this is an old freeway on-ramp and off-ramp, I believe. And basically after the Loma Prieta earthquake, a big earthquake, basically, it took down the freeway or made the freeway unsafe, so they demolished it. And this land basically sat for 20 years being unused, and they're finally able to get permission to farm and cultivate the land. And they're doing an amazing job. I mean, this is just a hill of vegetables growing. I mean, I see lettuces and I see sunflowers, I see, squash, tomatoes. This farm is actually where the freeway used to be. So before the earthquake, there's an earthquake, I think it was a Loma Prieta earthquake. This was a freeway on-ramp with a structure that basically had a freeway going above the city, but basically collapsed or was unsafe due to the earthquake. So this was just unused land, and they made this land into a farm to grow food for the locals. And I was lucky enough to be driving by here today because I was taking an alternate route to where I was going. And I was like, wow, we gotta stop and make an episode for you guys. So I'm here to show you what could be done really just over concrete. You could have a garden and grow some food. So we're at the entrance of Hayes Valley Farm, and this is what it used to look like. It was just basically, I see broken glass and debris and forks and basically just a wasteland of people throwing their junk. And if we go over the other side, this is a really good, comparison to show you what they're doing just on the other side. I'm probably sure they're gonna do it over here at some point. Here's their welcome sign. And over here on this side, they've made a raised bed, and it's really simple. All they did was they did sheet mulching, so that means they just laid down the cardboard on the bottom and they basically just piled up soil into mounds, and then they put some edging, so they have some riprap edging. This is basically broken up concrete and some pieces of wood as the edging of the bed. It looks like they just had cut down their fava beans because they are growing fava beans as a cover crop, and now they're planting some other things in this front bed. Such an amazing use of space. And even if you're not here at Hayes Valley Farm, you could do this in any space that's just barren and wasteland, like you saw in my video in Las Vegas in the middle of their city. San Francisco's doing it too. And next, maybe in the middle of your city, you could get a project like this growing to grow food and to teach people how to grow food. It's so important and we all need to eat. So let's get inside Hayes Valley Farm and check out what they're growing. All right, so we're here with Mark with Hayes Valley Farm, and he's gonna tell us more about how the farm came to be and some of the goals of the farm and why it's here in the middle of San Francisco on an old, on and off ramp to the freeway that's no longer here.
That's right. This is a lot that went unused for about 20 years, and we finally got permission to start building soil and transform it. We're building soil, we're building community, and we're showing that you can grow food in a polyculture, which means we're not just growing rows and rows of the same vegetable. When you do that, it requires a lot of pesticides and artificial fertilizers, and then it needs to be transported from distant farms. We're growing food locally for the community. We're teaching the community how they can grow food in their own gardens, and they can also come here and grow it, as a part of the community. It's really fun. It's a great place to come hang out with people, make new friends, and actually get some good food, and just have a blast.
So this used to be the back of the freeway on-ramp that used to go right here, and as a child, my parents would take me on this freeway off-ramp to go into San Francisco. So when I'm sitting here, it was a slope, and you can't really see this on the camera, but it's a slope and they basically stepped it and just put soil, and they made steps and then they made mounds on the steps. So this is like a walkway, and they have all kinds of just different vegetables growing. So I see lettuce, some beans, corn, zucchini, tomatoes, and in between all the rows, actually, they're growing clover, probably for a cover crop. It looks pretty amazing here. Let's move on and take a look at what else is growing here at the Hayes Valley Farm. This farm is about 2.5 acres or thereabouts, and they have many different areas and many different projects going on. A lot of it is actually hilly, and they're trying to terrace the sides of the hills that you just saw. But here is basically an example of two really simple raised beds. All they did was basically mound up the soil into two big mounds. We have a walkway here in the center, and they just started planting things like beans and peas, and I see some sage and some parsley, some tomatoes, and I see some kales over here, all different kinds of things they have growing here in the middle of San Francisco. This is just completely amazing. So welcome to the Freeway Food Forest here at Hayes Valley Farm. And what they're growing here is, you know, you can't plant on top of concrete and asphalt. So what they're doing is they have things in pots. You can grow in pots, in containers. So like I'm doing in my driveway, I have wine barrels. They're just having to use gardening pots here and growing all kinds of food in pots. And probably maybe what they're gonna eventually do is basically line this with all this cardboard sitting right next to me. And then they're basically gonna bring in the compost or horse manure and wood chips or the mixture they're using and just build this up. So they're gonna put cardboard and then just a lot of compost, and then they're just gonna plant in that. And most roots don't go down that far, and I think they've already done it in the other section that we were just looking at. So let's take a look at some of the crops they have here in the Freeway Food Forest. So we're here in the Freeway Food Forest, and they got all kinds of trees, from apple trees, nectarines, plua trees. They got some Beverly Hill apples here too. That's the variety. Even some almond trees, and I kind of wonder how some of these trees are gonna grow here in San Francisco. Now, San Francisco, it doesn't get too hot, but it doesn't freeze and get too cold either, so it's kind of right in between. So it can be probably challenging to grow something like tomatoes that like some heat. So you need to get very specialized varieties like the San Francisco fog variety of tomato that's gonna maybe do better here. But what is doing really good here is this idea here, and I've never seen this before. They have basically a chicken wire, and it's just made into a circle, and they fill this with like mulch. So it looks like a lot of just, leaves and really light compost with some horse manure in here. And they planted potatoes inside here, and the potatoes have sprouted up, and they're growing all these potato plants. You could probably plant other things in these to come out too, you know, as long as the stuff you're putting in is not too fine, it won't come out. You can see below, a little bit is falling out, but it's growing really well. The potatoes just coming out, and probably at the end they're going to open this up and have a lot of new potatoes at the end of the season. The other thing I wanted to point out, what they're doing here, and I haven't seen this done before, is at the base of every tree, and this happens to be a Su Li Asian pear, they have this green stuff. And I'm like, man, what is this green stuff? Basically what they're doing is they're taking their clippings of like the clover, which is clover fixes nitrogen. They're cutting it down, and then they're putting it at the base of every tree to add nitrogen into the soil for the trees. So that's another really cool sustainability thing they have growing on here. And I've seen them growing the clover all over at different locations. So let's move on and check out another aspect of the Hayes Valley Farm. So here's a small bed of fava beans here. And what they're doing with the fava beans is they're growing these strictly for the nitrogen fixing capabilities. And as you saw in the videos I did, they're growing these, they're gonna cut them down and then till this under to basically add nitrogen to their soil, because they're basically working with some compost, horse manure, and wood shavings. And they're trying to bring in a lot of fertility, so they're trying to use plants that they can grow on site to make this more sustainable, and I really admire them for doing that. One of the reasons for the Hayes Valley Farmers for Education, and they have a workshops that they give here. It says they have a kitchen gardens Tuesday at 6:30 p.m., fruit trees on Sunday at 11:30 a.m., outdoor yoga Thursdays at 1:30 p.m., and permaculture boot camp Sundays at 10 a.m. So if you're here in San Francisco, maybe you can get more information about the workshops and everything going on here. They also probably need volunteers. If you want to learn about farming, come here and volunteer. It's great to get hands-on experience, and that's how you learn.
Yeah.
So I hope you've enjoyed the visit to Hayes Valley Farm today. To learn more about Hayes Valley Farm, visit their website at hayesvalleyfarm.com. So once again, this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com, and keep on growing. And if you live in the city, it's very important to grow in your space, at your home, outside in a container, or wherever you can. We'll see you next time.